Hello, YouTubers. You are joining a new talk show that has it all. She's got style. She's got flair. She's the answer to all of your problems. She is not afraid of anything. She's not afraid to shine. And she's here for you. She will be answering questions found on YouTube and some questions that she made up of her own. They joined her in 5 seasons of different topics. She will be doing introductions, talk topics, answering questions from Google, song of the day, the people's thoughts, and the closing. I can't lie when I watch my baby. 24 episodes per season, 5 seasons of pure honesty. Please join her today on her new talk show, The Beauty of General Life with LadyTAngel. Her real name is Taylor Shanice Raymond. Join her today because she is not afraid to shine. If it wasn't there, yeah, and I'm rubbing it. Oh, you wanna know if we can make this confidential between me and you? We already did it. Between me and you. Hey, YouTubers. Yeah, thank you guys for joining me once again on my talk show, The Beauty General Life with LadyTAngel. Yours truly, that would be me. And I'd like to thank you guys so much for being here today. Okay, we are still pretty much at the start of season 2. We are up to episode 6, so we're moving pretty fast right now. And the title of the episode is called Fashion That You Can Hook. Every time that was pretty interesting. Like, at the end of this episode, you'll see like a whole bunch of examples. Instead of me showing you videos, I like to show you pictures to make it all easier. Okay, and before we get started with talking for a little bit, I'd like to show you my outfits for this episode today. Now, this I find pretty cute. I mean, I found this at Kmart. I mean, it is just an adorable little thing. I mean, it's a two-piece, but it's tied together. I mean, you probably can't really see it because of the lighting. But the design on here is a flower pattern. And it's only show at the top. I mean, right now it's just like the little sleeves right here. And, you know, the back is plain. So it's only this part. Like, it's really a two-piece, but it's tied together. I don't know exactly what they call it. I'm not really pursuing a career in fashion, so I don't know what they call it. But that's my outfit for this episode today. And we're going to do the same as usual. You know, talk for about maybe 3 minutes. And then at the end of the episode, I'm going to show you guys some examples. So just sit back and enjoy. Okay. Fashion that you can hug. And the topic we are going to be covering is certain fashions that catches your eyes. You know, fashion that catches your eye. I mean, for one example, one fashion that definitely catches your eye is something that has bling. Now, it's like, for example, you'll see, like, maybe sort of like, I mean, rhinestone design shirts and pants. I mean, not just silver rhinestone, but multicolor. I mean, especially when they have multicolor, it really brings out the entire outfit. Like, when I was a teenager, I've always been a big fan of bling and rhinestones. You know how they say diamonds are a girl's best friend, and mine still is, but I'm more plain now. I mean, what you can say. The only time I ever really stick to diamonds and rhinestone are jewelry of all types, sometimes the headbands, and sometimes the little hair accessories like the little clip-ins or the little comb-ins that you literally stick into your head and it just sticks out on the side. I'm not sure if you guys know what I mean, but I mean, you might want to look into it. I mean, they have a whole bunch of cute hair accessories out there, especially at certain retailers that you'll shop at almost every week, if not every day. But that's one good example of, you know, fashion that you can literally hug, like you just don't want to let go of. Okay, for a second example, I would say color. Like, nobody really enjoys playing in fashion. I mean, not unless it was like exercising, being in the house, cleaning. I mean, especially doing that, you know, somewhere where you really can't be seen. I mean, and like playing video games and yada yada. I mean, I could go on, but I'm not going to, because we're on a certain time limit here. But oh my god. Okay. I mean, but like I was saying, nobody really likes playing unless it's completely necessary. Or, no, like I was just saying before. But, no, it's like me, for example. I only ever really wear plain unless I'm, outside just doing one or two errands and then going back home or whatever it is that I be doing. You know, somewhere where people can't really see me or don't really care enough to see me. I mean, that's when I wear plain, but when it comes to me going out and everything, I like to dress up. I mean, it's like when you guys had saw me in season 1 through episode 21 and 22, where I was trying too hard on the hair, the clothes, the makeup, the cat eye makeup that I had did. I mean, I also did that at the start of season 2, episode 1 and 2, I believe, if you guys were really paying attention. I mean, if not, then it's okay, but you can always look back on that later. I had the cat eye makeup on then, but you guys probably couldn't see it very well, because I didn't put too much on like I did in season 1. But that was really the only time I had tested it, and I looked pretty good in it, actually. Not to brag or anything. I mean, it's like this top that you guys are seeing me with right now. I had wore this on the night of New Year's Eve, actually, when I had shot that video with my best friend Talicia. I mean, I had wore this top then, but it was too dark in that club for you guys to see me in it. But you guys are seeing me in it right now. This is the same top I had wore on New Year's Eve, my earlier uploads. Make sure you check that out. It's also in my playlist, which I had created for you guys to make it easier for you to see things. But that's a second example of tying in of outfits that you can literally hug color. And for a final example, accessories. Now it's like certain dresses, certain blouses that you may see in the stores. I mean, it's like they have the necklaces that they literally tie to the shirt. I mean, whether it's like short, long, and sometimes they have that on turtlenecks too, but I mean, you rarely ever see that nowadays. I mean, it all depends on where you are, because they don't have that everywhere. But I find when certain retailers, you know, display those and they actually make those and do that, I mean, that's what I find really completely attractive. I mean, I really enjoy when they tie accessories literally to the certain things that you'll see out on display, if not in store. I mean, at first I felt like when I had first seen that, it's like I felt like that they were trying too hard, but at the same time they were doing the right thing. So that I find very, very, very creative. And I have certain shirts about that right now, but I barely ever wear them. Now, for some reason, I think it's because it's the winter time, and you know, times like those, it's best for warmer weather, like basically spring and summer. I mean, that's what I was trying to say. But that's a third example of fashion that you can hug. I mean, this is the people's stars are for. If you thought something was missing from the episode, something you'd like to add, what you thought about my answers and my talk topic, make sure to add that in the comments below. No hashtag necessary for people's thoughts. Just make sure you're participating and sharing the videos. And before you go, make sure to hit that like and that sub. And it's always appreciated and completely necessary. Okay. And the question of the day. And anyway, that concludes the episode in case you guys didn't catch that. Okay, question of the day before we go here. And I'm going to try to cover something from what we had just talked about in this episode. Like how I promised myself I'll keep doing throughout season 2. Instead of what I had there for episode 1 in season 2. Okay. Question of the day. Okay, well, what's the thing that you like most seeing on Blouses women? I mean, I want to know your answers. I want to know all of your thoughts. Okay, so make sure when you're answering to this question of the day that you're hashtagging and then you put down your answer. I mean, but answer first, hashtag next. I don't really care. Just make sure you add that hashtag so I don't confuse you with trying to do something else, like something you're concerned about or replying to the people's thoughts. I mean, question of the day, the reason why I add the hashtag, you guys should probably know that by now, but in case not, in case you're new to the whole experience, it's because I want to make sure I separate everything and I don't get anything mixed up and confused. I mean, I'm not saying I can't read, but I like to keep things organized, especially on my YouTube page. So hashtag, please, to submit your answer to me. But I want to thank you guys for joining me in this episode. Right now, I'm going to leave you guys with a peace out, and I will see you guys later. Bye.